good learning strengths. Already we have completed the properties of all gels, either the physical or chemical properties of all gels. Today we are going to learn about the alkenes. Alkenes are the unsaturated hydrocarbons, and these alkenes are called as olefins. The meaning of olefins is oil forming. These olefins, the lower alkenes will be forming oily products with the bromine or chlorine. Due to this reason, these are called as olefins. And as we discussed that, alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbons and they will be having a double bond. And the general form of alkenes is CnH2n. The general formula of alkenes is CnH2n, and these alkenes are the unsaturated hydrocarbons with one double bond. And these alkenes are very reactive elements. Alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbons. Due to that reason, they are very reactive and will be available in free nature. And these lower alkenes will be available in less quantity in the coal gas. And if you want to get more quantity of the lower alkenes, we can produce it by cracking of petroleum. By cracking of the petroleum, we can get a higher amount of alkenes. And homologous series of alkenes. What is homologous series? If the organic hydrocarbons or the organic compounds with the same physical and chemical properties, if they are differed by CH2 group, those hydrocarbons or organic compounds are called as homologous series. For example, if you see here C2H4 and C3H6, they will be differed by CH2. Are they differed by CH2? Yes, they are. These both are differed by CH2. Not only this, even these two are also differed by CH2 group. That's why, as if the successive organic compounds are differed by CH2 group, then we will call them as homologous series. And now we will find out the molecular formula, Mendel's formula, and the structural formula, trivial names as well as IUPAC names of these alkenes. And C2H4 is the first member of the alkenes. C2H4 is the first member. Why? Because we are having the double bond between carbon and carbon. That double bond will be possible only among two carbons. That's why this C2H4 is the first member of the alkenes. And the condensed formula is CH2 double bond CH2. And the structural formula is between carbon and carbon, they are having a double bond, and then carbon to hydrogen, it is having a single bond. Next, trivial name is, the common name is ethylene. Okay, as if it is near to ethyl group, that's why we use the ethyl and E, as if it is having a double bond E, ethylene. And the IUPAC name, if it is having two carbons, we will call it as ethene. And the, it is having the name as alkenes, this suffix, ene suffix will be added so that we will be getting ethene. In the same way, we will see for the next members of the family. This is the second member of the family, C3H6. And we can write it as C2 double bond, then this is C2. How many hydrogens we have completed here? 2 we have completed, still we are having a 4. Okay, then we can take it as double bond C2. How many hydrogens do we get here today? 4. Is it sufficient? 4 plus 2 is 6 and this is a 3. Then let us see the structure. So, 3 carbons, between 1 carbon it will be having a double bond. And here, and here. Let us see whether it is satisfying the tetravalency and it is following all the rules or not. So here if you observe, this carbon is having all the 4 bonds. Now if you observe here, it is having 2 bonds, 3rd bond, 4th bond. And here it is also 1, 2, 3, 4. So that it is satisfied. Okay, it is satisfied. Even we can write the structural formula even in this way. In this method, CH3. Okay, only one double bond will be present here, and the condensed formula is the abbreviated formula, the short notation. Okay, and then here we will call it as 3 carbons are there. That's why this is called as propylene. Okay, and if 3 carbons are there, prop, and according to the suffix. Propene. Okay, then the next one, C4H8. So here we will write this one as CH3, then CH2, CH, double bond, CH2. Now let us see whether it is having a 4 carbon and 8 hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. Then how many hydrogens? 8 hydrogens. 3 plus 2 is 5, plus 1, 6, 7, 8. It is satisfied with this. Now let us see the structural formula for the C4H8. The structural formula is, first you have to draw the 4 carbons, that is chemical system. Then you can place 1 number. You can place anywhere, either here or in between these 2 carbons, or in between these 2 carbons also, you can place the double bond. Then afterwards, we have to balance it with the, we have to find out whether it is satisfied with the valency or not. So this is a 4. Now, here one more hydrogen. And now here, here. These are the hydrogens, and this is one of the structures for the butane. Okay, butane. And we can write the other structures also. That here we can change the double bond. If we are placing here, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. So according to the number we will be giving towards the very the double bond will be placed between the very least numbers. Between the least numbers of the carbons we will be placing the double bonds. So we can take the numbering either from the right side to left side or from the left side to right side. So here in this way we can take, or if I am taking here, I am taking from between 1 and 2. If I am taking from this side, it is getting between 1 and 2. If I am taking from this also, it will be among 1 and 2 itself. Otherwise, I can place the double bond between 2nd and 3rd carbon also. That is another structure. Okay. So, like that here, if the formula, molecular formula is same, and if there is difference in the structural formula. Okay, in this way also we can write it. And here already 3 bonds are there, only 1 more hydrogen. And here, three more hydrogens. Okay, so this is another structure. Here it is from first between the first carbon and the second carbon, right? Here it is between the second carbon and the third carbon. And another structure also we can draw for this butene. That is okay. So it is double bond is present between the first carbon and second carbon, and one carbon is a branched carbon. Another carbon we have taken as a branched carbon. So here 1, 2. So this is one hydrogen, another hydrogen, and here this is satisfied, and here also it will be having three more hydrogens, and here it is also having three more hydrogens. Or sorry, I place it down. Okay, here also we can see a double bond is between the first carbon and second carbon, but only the change is it is a branched carbon. Branched carbon. So that for butene, or this is the IUPAC name is butylene. Okay. And this is called as butene. Bute is the root word and E is the suffix. That's why it is called as the butene according to the IUPAC names. And isomers. As if here we got the three different structural formulas for the same molecular formula. If the molecular formula is same and different structural formula is given, we call it as isomers. So for butene, we can get three isomers. So butene will be having three isomers, and the isomers will not be possible for the elements which are below the butene. Understand? That means butene and above, it can follow the isomers. It will be following the phenomena of the isomerism. So this butene will be having the three isomers. And in these alkenes, we'll be having the two types of isomerism. Two types of isomers will be available. That two types of isomers are, one is the chain isomerism. One is the chain isomers. And the another one is position isomers. Position isomers. The chain isomers are, if the chain is striped, see here, this is the striped chain, then we can call it as chain isomerism. Okay, this is called as the chain isomerism. If there is a difference in this chain itself, if there is a difference in this chain itself, in the arrangement of the chain itself, if there is a difference, then we will call it as okay. Now here, if you see this example, this chain is a striped chain, but here this is a branched chain. That's why we call this isomerism as a chain isomerism. And if we go for the position isomerism, if there is change in the position of the double bond, here there is a change in the position of the double bond. That's why we can say these two structural formulas as a position isomers. There is a change in the position of the double bond. Now please observe this one. Here it is between the first carbon and the second carbon, we can find the double bond, and here between the second carbon and the third carbon, we can find the double bond. As if there is change in the position of the double bond, we can call these isomers as the position isomers. I hope it is clear, children. Thank you.